How's this affected you, Lawrence? Because you own, you know quite a few hotels. You own lots of property in the city. You employ a lot of people. How's this affected you mentally?
I would say, without any doubt, that this has been the toughest time of my 55-year existence.
Do you feel a massive pressure?
Not as much now, but certainly when hotel closed, no money coming in whatsoever, investors coming after me, and the Echo coming after me, and the council coming after me all at the same time, doesn't make for a pretty existence. So I pretty much turned my phone off. Just planted flowers on the roof. Learned how to breathe to get rid of that anxiety that you obviously feel. And I was lucky, really, because one of the main investors, that was the first one to state that if he doesn't get his money back, you know, he's gonna be in trouble, which went in the Echo. They ran that same story probably 15 times, just with different clickbait headlines. He's actually become the chairman of the investors, and I've now got 95% of the investors actually voted for us now to be in favour. And I probably made a mistake at the time when the Echo were hitting me with all those stories, since 11 collapses, all this sort of stuff, which we haven't. In essence, I just went undercover and decided to just say nothing because I didn't know when we were going to open. I didn't know when I could, you know, refinance the hotels. There was no fund in the world that wants to finance hotels when they don't know when it's going to open up again. So I had nothing to say. And I felt if I would have said anything, the Echo would have pulled it up and torn it to shreds. And I would have probably shot the only bullet in the chamber. And I decided to stay quiet. Because I stayed quiet, that void that was created then became an extremely negative one, because the Echo was saying this, that, and the other. And then the investors would see that. And they would just go, well, clearly he hasn't said anything, so we must be doing whatever. And just for the record, you know, I work 18 hours a day. I still work 18 hours a day. My wages are extremely low. I live in the Shankly Hotel. I don't have a single asset in the world. My car's 8 years old. I do not spend money. And every single penny that came into the business went into the bricks and mortar of that business. And I never took anything out. Still to this day, I haven't. And the proof of that is the administration that came in, I think they would have threw me out of my ear if it did, and I didn't. And because of that honesty, I'm still here today, and because of that honesty, my investors have voted, 95% of them voted in favour of keep me where I am, to battle. Because the other thing is, our hotels are not like other hotels. Oh. They've been sort of designed and built with my strange, warped mind. So I understand the importance of being different and not being part of the same cabal that everyone else sort of wanders towards.
The Willy Wonka Hotel, I was telling people.
You know, really, we done one in Rainhill, and one of the guests came in did a week, and she was saying, you know, everyone's can't wait till it opens, whatever. Don't we call you Randy? And I said, no, what do you call me? We call you Willy Wonka. I went, oh.